Science is fundamental to really understanding what's happening, why things are changing, and what we could do to address it. There's not a better job you could do.
There we go, and you can take a seat.
I'm Phil Stevenson. I'm a professor of plant chemistry here at Kew Gardens, and I lead Kew's work on plant and fungal traits. Kew is certainly a very famous botanic garden, famous globally. It's a beautiful space for people to come and enjoy the plants and the open spaces, the beautiful buildings. But actually, there is also a very important science program that is underway here at Kew, studying plants and fungi and trying to understand how we can use our scientific expertise and knowledge to develop solutions to some of the most important global challenges, such as global climate change and trying to stop biodiversity loss. Science is fundamental to really understanding what's happening, why things are changing, and what we could do to address it. One of the most important things that Kew does is develop the inventory of life, this catalogue of life. We name and identify plant and fungal species. I think last year we identified nearly 200 species. And so by understanding what's out there, we're then in a much better position to consider what we can do to stop it or better understand what we might be losing. Well, I don't think anything is more pressing than the climate crisis. It's an existential crisis, essentially. You know, we are seeing it happening right now. Some of the work that we're doing in Uganda, for instance, with coffee, is where farmers are now not able to grow the coffee species that they were able to 10 years ago because they're no longer surviving. And so Kew's work is providing new species of coffee that are better adapted to those warmer, drier futures. And so, you know, we have an existential crisis that's happening right now for many people around the world, but Kew's work is actually able to address those right now. Well, one of our priorities as an organization is training the next generation, and this involves a whole host of different approaches. So we have formal degrees, mostly in postgraduate. We have something like 130 PhD students, around 100 master's students. But we also offer internships. So as an undergraduate, you could come here and spend a year in one of our labs working with one of our teams and get paid for it. So we offer school programs where schools can come here and learn about plants and get excited and understand much more about what the challenges are. One of the challenges we face in science is that the more we know, the more there is to know, and the more deep and more specialist knowledge you need to really investigate those. And so the more specialized you get, the smaller the pool of scientists you have. So we don't have huge cohorts applying for most of the jobs. If young people are looking for a rewarding job and one that's full of excitement and unknowns, then I couldn't recommend it highly enough. There's not a better job you could do. We discover new species here. We develop solutions to climate change. We develop new ways of growing food. We develop new foods. We help us understand some of the challenges that we face. And I couldn't think of a more rewarding job.